Okay, students, so as you are at home because of the COVID-19 virus, so all the classes were suspended. So for that, at home, if you want to study about physics, so we physics team, so we made some videos, the video lectures regarding the unit 4, that is what quantum mechanics and free electron theory. So these lectures will give to you, so you don't have to study at your home. So after we come back to the college, and you can easily follow the remaining syllabus, whatever you have left. So for that, we are making these videos. So first of all, let me introduce myself. As you know, I am myself, Dr. Santosh Kumar Alla. So today, I am going to discuss about quantum mechanics and free electron theory. Okay, so well, while going to start about quantum mechanics, so let me clarify to everyone that whenever you have any doubt regarding this physics lectures, so you can contact any faculty of physics faculty in our department. Okay, so by this I want to start quantum mechanics. So what is quantum mechanics? When I first heard this name quantum mechanics, so in my mind some doubt has come regarding what is the basic difference between classical mechanics and quantum mechanics. So what do you mean by classical mechanics? So classical mechanics, which we have already introduced in plus 1, plus 2, where this is simply you can call it as a Newtonian mechanics. So what is Newtonian mechanics? That means if a body of mass m, it is moving with a speed or with velocity, so then obviously what is the position and what is the momentum of the particular body, we can analyze or we can predict by the Newton's famous Newton laws, Newton first law, second law and third law. So that is what basically is come under category of the classical mechanics. So that we simply call it as a Newtonian mechanics. Now, unlike classical mechanics, quantum mechanics, it's only dealing with the bodies which are having the mass is very very less, and as well as the speed or velocity is very very high. So those things, for those particles or those bodies, we cannot use Newton laws. So for them, we cannot predict what is the position and what is the momentum of the particular particles. So further, we need another category of the mechanics, that is called quantum mechanics. Okay, well, so in quantum mechanics, as you already studied in previous classes, like Planck's quantum theory. So what is Planck constant quantum theory? So it is saying that unlike classical mechanics and unlike classical theory, the energy is released by a body or anything. So that energy is not a continuous energy. It is like a quantized. That means energy is come under into the discrete. That means it is like a individual small part of the energy. So it is a group of those small parts. That we can write like equation E is equal to n into h mu. So that means always here n is an integer, so like starting from 1, 2, 3 and 4 etc. That means what are the energy released by a body, it is always not in a continuous position, and continuous it is like a discrete. That means h mu, 2 h mu, 3 h mu, 4 h mu etc. like that. This is what Planck's quantum theory. Now where h mu, we can call it as a photon, that means quanta of packets. That means energy is liberated in terms of packets. That means packet, each individual packet is having energy is h mu. So whatever be the energy, for example, you say energy of this body or something, energy of this particle, you say that should be, it is in something multiple of some h mu should be there. So that is what Planck's quantum theory. Now, for quantum mechanics, where it is arise, by de Broglie's matter waves. So what is de Broglie matter waves? That we are going to understand about what are the matter waves. So before understanding the matter waves, so first we want to try to recollect what is the wave. So wave is naturally, it is a disturbance created in the medium. So in a medium, if there is a disturbance is created, that means energy transferred from one place to another place without moving the particles or without moving the what are the particles in the medium. So that is one wave. So for example, let's say if you take a longitudinal wave, that means sound wave, that means there is a variation of pressure. That means the wave is generated because of the variation of the pressure. So then the wave is generated, that is called longitudinal wave. In case of light wave, it is electromagnetic wave, that means electric field vectors, electric field which is oscillating, because of oscillating electric field, the light wave is generated, that is the light waves. So simply, if you say water wave, that means water wave, simply if you can understand water wave, so wave we say it is like this. Now in water wave, what happens? The displacement of the water molecule, so from this place will take place. That maximum displacement we call it as a amplitude. So that the wave equation we write generally y is equal to a sine omega t plus phi. That means y means the displacement of any particle or any position, any particle or molecule at a particular time is described by this equation. Y is equal to a sin omega t plus v. At a particular time we say y is equal to a sin omega t plus phi, where a is the amplitude of the wave. So what is the wave amplitude? This is the maximum displacement, that is called amplitude of the wave. So now this is a wave. This is for water waves. For water waves, the maximum displacement of the water. If you say sound wave, the maximum pressure variation, the maximum pressure density, that is called water sound wave. For the light wave, this is the electric field vectors E bar, that is the displacement of the electric field vectors. Like that, what de Broglie is saying that whatever we say, these are all, there is something like oscillating is there. But de Broglie is saying that, for example, if you take any particle, something like particle, now this particle is of mass L. Now it is moving, okay, it is moving some speed or some velocity, it is moving some velocity. Now this particle is always associated with some wave. It is always associated with some wave. What are the wave concept? That concept is completely different from this one. Okay, here the particle itself is moving with some velocity, but it is having the wave nature. That means this we can call it as a dual nature of the particle. That means wave nature as well as particle nature.